Now, we're here to discuss the silkworms and the boll weevils. Mm-hmm. We want to interest you from the advantage that the silkworms gives the East, and the disadvantage that the boll weevils gives to us over here.
All right.
In the West. The silkworms is very productive to China and all the eastern countries.
Mm-hmm.
Silkworms keeps the mills running. Yes, and keep the silk mills yawning and preparing to send silk to America.
Amen.
The American market is making demands for it. And these boys that works for 50 cents a day over here and girls for $3.50 and $4 a week, why, the boys that work for 50 cents, they want $3 to $5 silk shirt.
All right.
And the girl, she wants a $6 stocking and a $12 or $15 silk shawl, you know.
Uh-huh.
And that's very productive to the eastern market, don't you see?
Yeah.
And coming over here, they get a little speculative interest over here. But our destruction comes with the boll weevil.
All right.
Oh, he's a very little thing, but he brings on sorrow in the field.
Right.
And in the home, he caused the great commerce of the South to have to leave here.
Yes.
And the general business of the South went down to, just because that our greatest commercial interest was the cotton. And so the wickedness of the world and the sins of man is like the boll weevil. It's a eating cancer. Sin is an eating cancer to the mind. And it eats up your life. And eat up your thoughts. And eat up your good feelings. And it eats up the good desires you would do. Like the boll weevil eat up the cotton gold. So sin eats up the life of a good man or a good woman. It's destructive to you. Yes, but, and it's fine. And it winds up in death and sorrow and shame.
So come on, spirit.